like to welcome you to our drug-free rally. We'd also like to thank you in the way you have been behaving. Every time somebody visits the school, they say how much they love the way the rebels are paying attention. So give yourselves a round of applause for them.
My respects and thanks to everyone who's here. Thank you for showing up. We're here just to kick off the Red Ribbon Rally. For those of you who don't know what Red Ribbon is about, it's about a special agent that was killed in the line of duty, and that was DEA agent Enrique Camarena. He was undercover and he got so deep into the cartels that when they found out who he was, they had already taken a bunch of them down. So they kidnapped him and they killed him. So now we remember him by putting on a red ribbon like what I've got here. And most of you have also. And what that means is that you're remembering him and you're taking a pledge to be drug free. So that's what you're wearing right now. That's why you're wearing it. And that's all I have.
Hello, rebels.
Hello!
Hello, Rebels!
Hello!
Thank you so much for having us here today. And having myself and part of my staff here today. I brought with me some of Eagle Pass Police Department's finest police officers today to spare this special day with you. I was a rebel myself in more ways than one. Many, many years ago. And I went to this school here just like you, and I sat there many times in the gym, and I recall back in the day when they all would also bring police officers, and of all the people that ever brought up and spoke to students, it was always the police officers that brought the most attention to me. And I want to commend all of you right now that how well you pay attention. I see all of you, and I think the teachers are doing a wonderful job. One of the messages that I carry, and I'd like for you to listen very carefully, there are jobs as police officers and our jobs as teachers, and I know very well because I am married to one, have been for 22 years. And one of the things that I'm so proud of, other than that, and my three children, is what I do now as a chief of police. And I'm very honored today as well, not only because I'm here today, but today we brought aboard our Eagle Pass Police Department to our family. Three new, new police officers. Will they please stand up? I'm going to do it. Gabriela Rodriguez, Jose Valadez, and Cristina Flores. Thank you so much. When I was notified that I could be a guest speaker from Robert Lee, I was very honored. So I brought them with me so they can share this moment as well. One of my messages to all of our children here in our community, and not just Robert Lee, not our rebels, but certainly every child in our community, that we're celebrating this day like it was demonstrated by some of our students about the life and the career of Enrique Camarena. I made a presentation several years back in another part of town where I presented to them the life of Enrique Camarena. I brought up pictures about Tupac Shakur and Biggie Smalls, and I was surprised that a lot of people identified with that, but they could not identify with Enrique Camarena. I think that Robert E. Lee today made a very good demonstration of what his life's about, and I commend you for doing that. You give yourself a round of applause for that one. Thank you so much. You know, as police officers, one thing they're always concerned about is the safety of our children. But I do want to identify with you and let you know, and as well as parents, that the first line of defense against any child is not your teachers, it's not the police, it's your parents. Because education, ladies and gentlemen, it starts at home. Education does not start with your teachers, certainly does not start with police. Your education begins at home with your parents. By the time you start coming to school, ladies and gentlemen, it's because you are prepared to sit down and let the teachers do their job. I commend them so much because they have the work cut out for us with our children growing up. It's very important for us to identify. One of the things that I tell parents, I tell them, I used to hear this even when I was growing up. Ahí viene el policía, te va a llevar. How often do we hear that? I refrain from parents not using those phrases, because I want our children to grow up and knowing that we're your friends. We're also part of your line of defense. I don't like drugs, ladies and gentlemen. And if you remember anything that I said tonight, listen to what I just said. I do not like drugs. I do not like bullying in school. I don't approve it. I'll do anything that I can within my power, within my job, and some of the best police officers that are with me that are gonna help you grow up and be strong. As a parent, and well, a lot of us are parents here, one of the things that we want out of life, the only one, two things when our kids are growing up, there's two things, and everybody will agree with me. Number one, you stay in school, and number two, you stay away from what?
Drugs.
Stay away from drugs. Drugs are no good. We celebrate every year during this week of Red Ribbon, but let me tell you, it's one week that we celebrate it, but we must live it our entire lives, okay? We do our jobs. I gave a speech this morning to our community when we brought on board our new police officers and I introduced them to our city. And two things that I mentioned to the media and all our guests, to include the mayor of Eagle Pass and our city manager and staff, was there's only two things that I pray for every night. That our police officers do their jobs so you can tell your students and your children that they're gonna sleep well at night. And it wasn't gonna happen to them because our police officers are on the street doing their job. And the other thing that I pray for is that our police officers come home safe. And for that, ladies and gentlemen, I also tell you, be safe, stay away from drugs, and stay in school. Thank you so much for this beautiful day. Thank you.
With the canines. So let's give them a big round of applause. Thank you for coming in.
Good afternoon. How are you guys? My name is Jorge Mercado. I'm from the Montgomery County Sheriff's Office. I'm gonna go ahead and introduce my partner, Deputy Salado, and his canine partner, Tampa. Over here on the right side. Deputy Salon has been a canine officer for almost a year now. So he's gonna go ahead and show you guys what he does out in the field, right? And one of these boxes, there's a real narcotics, real drugs, right? He's gonna show you what Tampa does out when he goes out in the field. So go ahead, Deputy Salon.
Tanya's coming in with our canine officer, Roberto Martinez. She's from Holland.